Good morning, guys. In the last class, we were discussing about connections. So connections are used to join two structural members, and these members can be beam to column connection, you can have a beam to beam connection, or you can have column to column connections also. Other possibility of connection is also there. Now, in the last class, we discussed one type of connection, that is bearing type of connection. In this class, we will discuss another type of connection, that is high strength friction grip bolts. In short, this is also called as HSFG bolts. That is high strength friction grip bolts. So, we will discuss what is the mechanism by which the forces get transferred in high strength friction grips bolt. So let us discuss this. So basically this kind of bolts are used when the forces are large. So whenever we have large amount of force and we want to transfer, then we require a HSFG bolt. And whenever we have limited connection, a space, so a space for connection is limited. So we have very small space and we have to connect two members. In that case, again, we have to use an HSFG bolt. And this kind of bolt is also known as friction type of bolt. So now you understand why this is called friction type of bolt. Basically, this gives you an idea. What is the mechanism of force transfer in this kind of bolt? So if you think a little bit, you can get an idea how the forces are transferring in the two members connected by a bolt. So let us illustrate all this using an example or using a figure. So let's say I have one plate and I'm applying a force F, and I have another plate here. And these two plates are connected by a bolt. Now in this case also we will have force F because this system is in equilibrium. Now this force F is transferred through this bolt to this plate. So how this transfer is happening, and this happens due to the friction. So how this happens? So let's say when we tighten this bolt, there is a tensile force that gets generated inside this bolt. So there is a tensile force that gets generated. Now due to this tension, basically frictions come into the picture. So to illustrate that, let us take a cross section at this section. So if I cut from here and if I make another picture, something like this. So as I said, there is a tensile force that is getting developed inside this bolt. So we can show this tension force that is coming here. So this is the tensile force. Let's call this as a normal reaction or normal force N. Now if I see the equilibrium of this portion, there has to be same N that can come on the upper direction. Now due to this normal reaction, and because there is a friction coefficient or friction present at these two surfaces, there will be a friction force that will come on this surface, and the magnitude of this force will be mu times N, and the direction will be such that it will try to oppose the slip. So this will be in this direction. So there is a force at the contact, and that force is mu into N, and so this force is F, and there is a friction force mu times N is coming on this surface. And similarly, I can also draw the force diagram for the lower plate. So if I see, so this is the lower plate. So this friction force is coming in this direction. So on this surface, friction force will come on this direction. And there is a force that will come in this direction. So this, if I consider equilibrium of this plate, so F is equals to mu times N, and similarly if this force is mu times N, then this force has to be equal to F. So you see, finally this force F through mu N is getting transferred to this member. So this is the mechanism of friction by which the forces from one member gets transferred to the another member. In this case, important point is how much force I can transfer. It directly depends upon mu times m, that is what is the normal reaction and what is the friction coefficient. So to change the normal reaction, what I can do? To change or to increase the normal reaction, I can tighten this bolt little bit more. So n depends upon, so I can say n depends upon how many turns I have tightened the bolt. So tightening. So this is tightness, how much tightness we have inside this bolt. And mu will depend upon what is the surface. So whether it's a rough surface or a smooth surface, and correspondingly we can have different amounts of mu into n. So this all is here. Whatever we said, we can see. So the initial pretension in the bolt develops a clamping force at the interface of element being joined. So we have two elements that is joined, that is two plates, and if I apply a pretensioning force, that is tension force that is applied due to the tightening, that generates or that develops a clamping force, that is the normal reaction. Now the next point is the frictional resistance between the plate surfaces subjected to clamping force oppose its slip due to externally applied shear. So whatever the friction that is developing, this force tries to oppose the externally applied tensile force or shear force that we have inside this member, that gets opposed by the frictional resistance force that is developed between the two surfaces. So this shows a typical HSFG bolt. So a typical high strength friction grip bolt. So this is a typical HSFG bolt. So you see, this also has one component washer. So you have bolt, nut, and then another component that is washer. So I have a question. What is the use of this washer? So we have already said the mechanism of force transfer through the normal reaction. In light of that, can you tell me what is the use of this washer? Yes. In this case, basically, whenever you have a normal reaction, this normal reaction gets evenly distributed whenever you have a washer. So this is used to even distribution of clamping pressure or the normal reaction. If you have a rough surface, in that case your normal reaction will not smooth or not uniform. In that case you can apply a washer, because the washer is smooth, so normal reaction will be uniform in that case. That's the why we often use washer in HSFG bolts. The highest strength bolts are made from bars of medium carbon heat treated steel and from alloy steel. So basically different type of steel. So medium carbon heat treated steel and from alloy steel these bolts are made. So how we achieve higher strength? So basically their higher strength is achieved through quenching and tempering process or by mixing some alloying steel. These are the ways by which we can basically generate a higher strength friction grip bolts. So bolts are tightened until they have very high tensile stresses, two or more times that of the ordinary bolts. So if you compare, in case of ordinary bolts, whatever the tensile force we have, in case of HSFG bolt you have 2-3 times more tensile force, because the mechanism of transfer of the force is totally related to the tensile force that you have inside this bolt, and that's why you have to tighten more so that this bolt become more effective. So to tighten these bolts we often use many kinds of wrench, and one example is torque wrench. This is used to tighten these bolts. So let us see what is the difference between ordinary bolts that we discussed in the previous class. The mechanism in this case of force transferred is bearing. So mainly due to the bearing, and in this case the mechanism of force transfer is friction. So what is the major difference in these two kinds of bolts? So there is a two bolts. One is ordinary bolt here, and then we have HSFG bolts. So if you see an ordinary bolt, if we apply a friction of force F, and then what happens, this plates gets touched or gets bared against this surface. So there is a force that due to this plate on coming to this bolt in this direction. So overall a net force, so due to all these forces we can say there is a net force on this surface is coming in this direction. So if I take a cross section at this plane, then there will be a force that is coming in this direction. Similarly, due to this force, this surface will bear, and there is a pressure that is acting on this surface in this direction, and due to all this, a net force will come in this direction. Similarly, if I apply a force here, then corresponding bearing surface will be this one, and this plate will try to bear against this part of the bolt, and it will try to press in this direction. So we can say a total force will come in this direction. So basically this is the way by which our forces gets transferred because of the bearing action. So one plate bears against the bolt, and then this bearing gets transferred to the due to the shear of the bolt to the other part of the bolt. So this is the way by which forces gets transferred into the ordinary bolt. Now in HSFG bolt, I have already discussed this. So you apply a force F, and then there are tensile forces that get generated, and due to this force there is a normal reaction and friction coefficient, so we can have a friction force at this surface, similarly a friction force at this surface. So due to this friction basically forces gets transferred. So you can see shear loads are transmitted directly by bearing. So the mechanism of force transfer is bearing between the internal surfaces of force and the bolts. In case of HSFG bolt, transmit shear loads by friction between connected plates. So you see the forces are transferred by the transmission of shear is happening because of the friction between the connected plates. So this shows a typical ordinary bolt, and this shows a typical high strength friction bolt, so HSFG bolt. Now about HSFG bolt, details are given in clause 10.4 of IS 800-2007. So this clause says about friction grip bolts. So this part we already discussed, you can read yourself in the code, and then you will find whatever we discussed, that is the mechanism of force transfer is given in 10.4.1. Now another section, that is 10.4.3, this clause basically gives you how we can calculate design shear strength of HSFG bolt. So if you remember, in bearing type connection we calculated the bolt value by calculating the shear strength and bearing strength and taking the minimum of all this. So similar type of calculation we are going to do in case of HSFG bolts also. So let's first calculate what is the design shear strength of HSFG bolts. So code gives a formula to calculate the design strength of shear force, and this is the formula that we have, that is equals to mu f times n e times k h f naught divided by gamma m f. So what are the meaning of these terms? Mu f is the friction coefficient between two surfaces, and n e is number of effective interfaces that is providing the friction. So if we have something like this, In that case, this is the bolt here. In that case, there is only one surface, and this surface is basically this one, where you have friction force. So in this case, you will have Ne is equals to 1. Now if we have something like this, so let me show here. So if we have this kind of surface, and then you have one plate on the top, one plate on the bottom, and then you are connecting through a bolt. So now if I consider this bolt, there are two surfaces that is resisting the friction. One is this surface, another is this surface. So in this case, I have to say Ne is equals to 2. Now we have different value for KH, another constant that is given in the code. So KH is equals to 1 when my fasteners in the clearance hole, KH is equals to 0.85 when fasteners is oversized and short slotted hole. So fastener in this oversized and short slotted hole, and this is equals to 0.7 when we have long slotted hole. So these values are given in the code, that is IS 800. Now F naught, this is minimum bolt tension at installation. So whenever you are installing a bolt, you are tightening the bolt. So this is the minimum bolt tension that you have at the time of installation. You see, this force can basically decrease also with time. So we are not going into all this. So this force can be given by this formula, ANB times F naught, where ANB is the net area of the bolt at the thread. And this we already discussed in the previous classes, that is 0.78 times pi by 4 into d square. And F naught, that is a small f in this case, is proof of stress, and taken equals to 0.7 times FUB, where FUB is the ultimate tensile strength of the bolt. So whenever we will discuss one example, then you will see what all these terms are. And the gamma MF is equals to 1.1 if slip resistance is designed at service load, and this is equals to 1.25 when slip resistance is designed at ultimate load. So when you are designing at service load, you have a partial factor of safety 1.1, and when you are designing at ultimate load, you need a higher partial factor of safety, and that's why we have a partial factor of safety of 1.25. Code also gives the value of average friction coefficient. So this is given in table 20 of the code, and this gives you typical average value for coefficient of friction. For example, when surfaces are not treated, then in that case 0.2, surfaces blasted with soot or grit and hot dip galvanized, in that case 0.1. So similarly for other cases, we have different friction coefficient. So depending upon the surface type, we have to choose a friction coefficient from this table whenever we are applying this formula. Now if you have a long joint, in that case you have to use a reduction factor, and this is what we also discussed in case of bearing joints. The idea is same. So if you have a long joint, that is long connection, in that case forces are not basically not uniform. They follow some kinds of distribution, that is a parabolic distribution, or you can have some other distribution. That's why we need to multiply this design force by using some kind of coefficient, and this coefficient takes care of the reduction factor. So we have to basically, in that case, whatever the VDSF value that is coming, we have to multiply that using a reduction factor. And this reduction factor is same as we discussed in the previous class for bearing types of bolt. So this is given in clause 10.4.3.1, that is long joints. The provision for long joints in 10.3.3.1 shall apply for friction types of bolts also. So whatever we discuss for bearing connection, that is also applicable for friction types of bolt. Now this says if length is greater than 15 times diameter, in that case the reduction factor is equals to 1.075 minus LJ divided by 200 times diameter, and when beta this value is this value or 0.75 times beta LJ, and then we have to check whether this value is less than 1 or not. That is the thing that we have to multiply by a reduction factor to account for the long grip length or long joint. Now see, so one important point we have in this case, so if we have a bolt, HSFG bolt, if this bolt does not lose its friction, then we can calculate the force or design force using this formula that we discussed earlier, that is the case of design shear strength. But somehow if it loses the friction, means there is no friction acting at the point of time when it loses the contact, we cannot apply all this formula. So what we do in that case, we calculate design bearing strength. When this happens at relatively higher load. So when you have a service load, in that case bolts we have like a HSFG bolt, like a friction bolt. But if you have a higher load, that is ultimate load, what happens, this friction can lose. In that case, these plates will basically slip and they will touch the bolt and they will try to bear against the bolt. In that case, we have to consider these bolts as a bearing type of bolt. So you see, important point, when you have service loading condition, in that case these bolts will behave more like the governing mechanism will be shear. But when you have ultimate load, in that case governing mechanism will be bearing. So in this case you can also say friction. Now how to calculate the bearing strength, that is given in 10.2.4. So you see, the HSFG bolt will come into bearing only if the slip takes place. So whenever we have slip, then we have to calculate the bearing strength, and this is what we already discussed in bearing types of bolt, that is clause 10.3.4. So this is 10.3.4. So this clause you can find the calculation of bearing design bearing forces. So code says the design bearing strength of a bolt on any plate BDP governed by the bearing action can be calculated by this formula. And then this formula, that is VNP, that VNP can be calculated by this formula. And in this formula you have a term KB, and the KB is a smaller of these quantities. This we already discussed in the bearing connection, and E and P and all these terms are given. What are the meaning of this term? That is given in the code. So one important point, FUB, that is ultimate tensile stress of bolt, and FU, the ultimate tensile stress of the plate respectively. So this is for the bolt, that is FUB, and this is for the plate. D is the nominal diameter, T is the summation of thickness of connected plates. So if you have more plates, this thickness will be sum of all the plates that is experiencing bearing the stress in the same direction. So this you have to basically take care of. So you see, when you have a slip, in that case your bolt becomes a bearing bolt. In that case you have to calculate the strength of the bolt using both. First you have to consider failure due to the bearing, and then you have to also consider the failure due to the shear that we already discussed in the previous classes. So note that in case of slip, we also have to calculate design shear of a bearing type bolt according to clause 10.3.3. So this formula we already discussed in the previous classes. So dSV is equals to VnSV divided by gamma MV, and VnSV is given by this formula. There NS and NN, these terms are given here. So NN is the number of shear planes with thread intercepting, and NS is the number of shear planes without thread intercepting. And these are the nominal plane shank area, and this is the net shear area of the bolt at the thread. So these terms, if we put, then we can calculate the designed shear capacity of the bolt. So you see what we are saying, if we have a HSFG bolt, if there is no slip, in that case we'll calculate the total force by considering the friction. But if there is a slip, in that case we have to consider this as a simply a bearing type of bolt. In that case we have to calculate the total force or design force due to the bearing as well as shear, and then we have to take the minimum force. So whenever we have a slip, it becomes a bearing bolt. And generally when we have ultimate load, slip occurs. At service load, you have a friction mechanism by which these bolts can be have as a friction HSFG bolt. So let us illustrate all this using an example. So this example says an Indian standard angle section of size this carries a factored tensile force of this. So we have an angle section and we are applying a force of, so this force of, so this is the angle section and we are applying a force of, so this is the angle section, applying a force of 150 kilonewton. And the dimension is given, so this is, if you see cross section of angle, so this is 110 mm, this is 110, and this thickness is 10 mm, and it is to be joined with a 10 mm thick gusset plate. Design the joint using HSFG bolt. So if I try to sew, so let's say this is the plate and this is the angle section we have, and we want to join this. So this is the bolt by which we want to join this, and this we try to use HSFG bolt. Now there are two situations, when there is no slip and when there is a slip. So we have to consider both cases. Assume that a steel is Fe410 grade, bolt diameter is 20 mm, HSFG bolt of grade 8.8, and bolts are in clearance holes. So these all will be used to calculate the different constants. Mu value is 0.5, Ne is 1, and EP, all these values are given, and you have to assume that shear plane of the failure intercept the thread of the bolt. So you have a shear plane inside the basically intercept the thread of the bolt. So that we all have to consider, and then we have to solve this problem. So let us take first part. So we have been given 8.8 grade of bolt. So we can write ultimate strength of bolt, that is 800 MPa. If you remember, I have to multiply 8 by 100. So what is the net tensile area of the bolt? So net tensile area of bolt, so if you remember, this is equals to 0.78 into pi by 4, and this is a 20 mm diameter of the bolt, so this comes out to be 245 mm square. So when there is no slip permitted, in that case we can write F naught, that is minimum bolt tension, at installation and this this is equals to ANV times F naught. We can also write ANV times 0.7 times FUB. So you see from where all this coming, so 0.7 times FUB. So if you remember, we already said all this. So this is F naught. We are calculating this term F naught, and then we said this F naught is nothing but ANV times F naught, and then we also said F naught is nothing but proof of stress, that is 0.7 times FUB. So if I plug all this value, we can calculate this, and FUB in this case is 800. So 245 into 0.7 into 800. So this gives me a value of 137.2 kilonewton. So what is the designer strength? So design shear strength of HSFZ bolt. So that is VDSF. So this we already said, this formula. So mu f is given in this problem, so mu f is 0.5, so we can plug this, and Ne and kh is also given. So Ne is 1, so this Ne is 1, and kh we can calculate from the IS code, or we can look. So let's first put Ne is equals to 1. And then we can go to see IS code for KH value. So this KH value is given. So it should be given in KH values here. So this is 1 for fasteners in clearance hole, and that is the case in this problem. So KH is equals to 1, and we calculated F naught value, that is 137.2, and gamma F is 1.25. So this will give me 54.88 kilonewton. And you can also see for gamma F the IS code, and then you will find this value is 1.25. So basically what we have done, we have taken KH is equals to 1 for fastener in clearance hole. So how many bolts we will require? So if you remember, we have to transfer a force of 150 kilonewton. So number of bolt required this is equals to 150 divided by 54.88, that is 2.73 bolt. So this means we can provide 3 bolts. So let's provide 3 bolts. So now let us consider part B, that is when slip is permitted. So when slip is permitted, these bolts will be basically bearing types of bolt. So we have to calculate design shear strength as well as design bearing strength, and then we have to look for the minimum value. So let us first calculate the when the bolt fails in shear, that is design shear strength. So I am directly writing the formula, that is VDSB, that is 0.577 times FUB times NN times ANV divided by gamma MV. So this formula I am writing from IS 800, so I can write different value because we have already calculated the different terms. FUB we know that is the ultimate tensile strength of bolt, that is 800. NN is 1, that is 1 is intercepting the thread. ANB is 245 and partial factor of safety is 1.25. So this gives me a value of 90.43 kilonewton. Now when we have bolt in bear, then in that case we have to calculate design bearing strength. And the formula is VDPB, this is equals to 2.5 times KB times D times T times FU and divided by gamma MB. So I am not going into the detail of this formula because we already discussed this in the previous classes. So KB is nothing but minimum of E by 3D naught, P by 3D naught minus 0.25 and FUB by FU and 1. So we can calculate all these values. Eccentricity is basically in distance is 40. This is given in the problem. So you see E value is given, that is 40 mm, pitch value is given, that is 60 mm. So end distance and pitch distance is given and diameter is 20, and this is 60 divided by 3 into 20 minus 0.25, and this is 800 divided by 410 and this is 1. So this all gives me a minimum value of 0.667. So we can calculate design force when we have bearing action, that is 2.5 times 0.667 times 20 times 10 times 410 and this divided by 1.25, and this gives me a value of 109 kilonewton. So you see minimum of 2, so 109, and here I have 90.43. So minimum of 2 is 90.43. So a strength of bolt so this is equals to 90.43 kilonewton. So we can calculate number of bolt required in this case, that is 150 divided by 90.43. So approximately we have to provide 2 bolts in this case. So this ends basically our calculation of design forces in friction types of bolt, that is HSFG bolt. So that there are 2 situations, you can have a slip or you can't have a slip. When you have a slip, you have different formula to calculate the design force, and when you don't have slip, in that case you have a different formula to calculate the design force.